There's something in the Bahrain air tonight, and I'm not just talking about the sand. Our brightest minds have thrust their brightest ideas into the spotlight of the Sakhir circuit this evening as we look ahead once more to a Grand Prix that has thrilled us so consistently in the past. We'll be racing around 3.36 miles of the magnificent Bahrain International Circuit today, with 15 corners and two DRS zones into turns 1 and turn 11. That should create some good passing opportunities. Keep an eye out for drivers locking the front left down into the tricky braking zone of turn 10. Bahrain has showed us many times in the past, though, Anthony Davidson, that a good strategy will only take you so far. Beyond that, you need good racecraft and you need good consistency.
And a little bit of luck too, I'd say. This is one of those circuits where the safety car always seems to come out just at the right time to condense the field together and mix up the cars on different strategies. It's hard on brakes, it's tough on fuel, and the main overtaking opportunity is down into turn one, where it's easy to outbrake your opponent and potentially have a bit of argy-bargy as well.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. It's Mercedes in pole position then, and starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Raikkonen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Verstappen, Massa, Perez, Grosjean, and Esteban Ocon, Kvyat, Hülkenberg, Kevin Magnussen, and Stroll, Sainz, Palmer, Fernando Alonso, and Stoffel Vandoorne, Wehrlein, and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
You should have some space going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. last this lap of the race. Keep this up.
Now open.
distance is 14.9 seconds. distance to teammate, 29.1 seconds. seconds.
And Mercedes have pulled off a great victory here today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. We see a new name at the top of the championship table as we reach the end of the Grand Prix weekend. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Marcus Ericsson. He's clearly got a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, and he's matured a lot over the past few seasons, which served him well today.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, good work from Force India this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye, and see you again next time.